Hi, this is Asing. You are now watching Asing Math TV. In this video, we will find out the possible cause of dimension error when using the matrix function in the calculator. First, let's input all the matrices given. So we press mode for 3 times until we see the matrix function number 2. And we should define the matrix first. So shift 4 and choose 1 to define the dimension. So we have matrix A. Dimension is 3 by 3, so M represents the number of rows, so we have 3. N represents the number of columns, so 3 as well. So matrix 1, 1, so first row, first column, we have value 1, so we press 1 and equal. First row, second column, we have 2 and press equal. First row, third column, we have 3 and press equal, and so on. So we have 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, and 9. After that, press AC to continue. Now we should define matrix B. So shift 4 again, define dimension 1, B number 2. Matrix dimension 3 rows and 2 columns for matrix B. Value 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6. Done. Also AC to proceed. Now we want to determine the inverse of matrix A. So shift 4. To call a particular matrix, press 3. A is 1. So we press inverse to obtain the inverse matrix. And we obtain mat error because the determinant of matrix A is equal to 0. We know that to obtain the inverse of a matrix is equal to 1 over determinant times n joy, since the determinant is 0, which means that we obtain 1 over 0, which is undefined. That's why we obtain mat error for the inverse of matrix A. How about the inverse of matrix B? Let's try. So press AC, shift 4 to call a particular matrix number 3. This time we will choose matrix B 2. And we press inverse and we will obtain dim error. This is because matrix B is not a square matrix. For any inverse of a matrix, the matrix itself must be a square matrix, otherwise we will never have inverse. So that's why dimension error. Now let's try for C. We have B times A, so matrix B, so AC again, shift 4, call a particular matrix. We want to have matrix B and we times matrix A. So shift 4 again, call a particular matrix, call A, and we press equal. So we obtain dimension error again. This is because the column, the number of columns that the first matrix has is not equal to the number of rows that the second matrix have. So we have to bear in mind that to make sure that the product of the matrices is applicable, we have to make sure that the value of Q is exactly the same as N, which means that the number of columns of the first matrix is equal to the number of rows of the second matrix in order for them to be defined when we multiply. How about we take B times C? Let's try. So AC again, shift 4. To call a particular matrix, 3, so B times shift 4, call a particular matrix, C, and we press equal. So dimension error again. This is because, as we can see, we did not define C before. If let's say we want to check out whether we have defined a particular matrix or not, very simple, we press shift 4, and we just have to choose edit number 2. If we choose C, and we obtain dimension error, which means that we never defined this matrix before. So that's why if we did not define any matrix when we want to perform any calculation, for sure cannot. And we will obtain dimension error. Okay, that's all for this video. Thanks for watching. Hope you like this. See you.